And if we're getting a one to go signal, we'll come to green next time by 10 laps, and the top two will race their way into the Ironman Classic. The richest Ironman Classic in history. Kenneth Howe not making the call. Defending track champion Jason Barrett and Hazard Kentucky's Steve Stallings will bring the field to green here in the 10-lap last chance B-Main number one. The fire at the barrel. You see set up on a Ute tire there off turn number four. Eyes on him, and here we go. In the top two trip, Gerald may have mashed the nose down on one of the inside Ute tires there, getting off into turn one, trying to get around Steve Stallings there on the initial start. Meanwhile, Jason Barrett showing a way out in front in the V5 machine. Steve Stallings is second, and the racing school teacher, the coach David Payne, he will go to position number three right there around Gerald. And you know, young Trip Gerald, he's going to go around. Doug Smith goes around, and Stephen Eversaw also collected. Back here behind the main grandstand area, they've got a sale going on. All t-shirts, $10 a piece, so three for 25. Two down, eight to go. Jason Barrett with the field in tow, they'll fire him there. At the start barrel, setting up off turn number four. Eyes on him, and here we go. And a Barrett will lead the parade off two down the back straightaway. Steve Stallings is second. David Payne out of Murphy, North Carolina, nipping at his heels from that third spot again. Only the top two will transfer on. Payne had problems in his qualifying. Started back in the sixth position, up to third, and trying to get second from Stallings. Off turn two down the back straightaway. The coach, David Payne, goes from sixth to second here in the early going of the last chance showdown, B-Main number one. And the coach may be looking for more as he is tracking down race leader Jason Barrett as we start to work toward the midpoint of this first last chance at B-Main. Duffield works through turn three off of turn number four. The halfway signal goes down, five to go. Barrett the leader, Payne is second, Stallings third, Doug Smith first. Stephen Eversaw is fifth, then it's Donnie Everman and Daniel Dial. Payne gonna take a look to the outside of Barrett through turn three and four. Not able to make a move right there. Will he try it again down in turn one and two? He's going to step to the outside of turn two to try to get a good run down the back straightaway. But he'll fall back in line behind Barrett down in the turn number three. There's something there, Bill. Payne jumps in. He'll try to go in above Barrett again. This time, though, side by side for the race lead. Off two down the back straightaway. And the racing school teacher tiptoes around the top shelf where Daddy keeps the Playboys hid. Off of turn number four as the two to go signal goes down. The racing school teacher, David Payne, goes to the race lead. As they work down the back straightaway, they'll come off turn number four, and the white flag waves. One lap's going to settle it here. Then last chance showdown, B-Main and number one. Payne down the back straightaway here for the final time. Brings that machine off of turn number four. The racing school teacher, David Payne, out of Murphy, North Carolina, winner B-Main number one, second. Will be Jason Barrett. He'll transfer on third. Will be Steve Stallings. Fourth goes to Stephen Eversaw. Fifth to Doug Smith. Then it will be Donnie Everman and Daniel Dial. Your top two to transfer on. Second in the B5 out of Waco, Kentucky, Jason Barrett, and the winner of last chance showdown, B-Main number one. Feature winner last night at Tri-County Racetrack in Brasstown, North Carolina in the Payne Racing Gibson Motorsports Capital Race Car Machine out of Murphy, North Carolina. Big round of applause for the racing school teacher, Coach David Payne. And Chris Tilley, the second and final B-Main's coming up. I need my Warlock Race Car.
So Wells and Fisher on the front row of this one. Doug Smith has already taken the first series provisional tonight. And looks like right now Steve Stallings has the Iron Man provisional. He is the highest car not in the show, fourth in points. So here we go. Terry Hicks, Derek Fisher are going to be on the front row of this one. And here we go, Derek Fisher up front, Todd Coffin, Billy Ogle desperately trying to get into the show tonight. Billy Ogle Jr. sits in third. He's not currently in a provisional spot, so he's desperately trying to get into the show as Derek Fisher currently leads Todd Coffin, Billy Ogle Jr., Johnny Wheeler, and Terry Hicks. Only two go to the show. Billy Ogle Jr. right now on the outside looking in. Two to go right here for Derek Fisher. Todd Coffin. The laps are winding down. Billy Ogle Jr. on the outside looking in. Derek Fisher is going to win the second last chance race. Coffin second. Billy Ogle Jr. misses the show by one spot. Johnny Wheeler fourth. Jerry Rutherford fifth. Your winner in car number 38, the Mike Schwartz Racing Longhorn out of Olympia, Kentucky, Derek Fisher. Second, what about him, Junction City's Todd Coffin in the 35. He's in the show and missing the show, the 201 of Billy Ogle Jr. He misses the show tonight.